My name is John Thomas. I'm just your ordinary college guy. I hate class, I go out on the weekends, and I have a girlfriend. Life was pretty normal. That was until I got Muff. It was the fall of 2001, and my girlfriend Liz and I were in the middle of a passionate relationship. We were the best of friends, and nothing was going to break us apart. Or so I thought.
Muff, don't you, John? It tastes so good, doesn't it?
Stop this! Stop! You're gonna get us killed!
What, you don't want my mammoth muff?
Watch out!
That's how I got Muff. I pleaded with Liz that the dog was probably going to get smashed on the road by some other careless driver. She reluctantly agreed.
Oh my god, he looks just like my old dog when I was growing up. Oh, you cutie.
I named the dog Muff for the sole reason that Liz almost killed all three of us by fooling around with one of her Perkins mammoth muffins. I had officially found myself a new best friend.
So, when are you gonna get rid of him?
He's not a sea monkey, Liz. You just don't flush him down the toilet when you get tired of him. It takes hard work and patience.
Liz, however, was not amused.
There you are! Oh my god, get this goddamn dog off me! I swear, if he doesn't stop fucking everything in sight, then...
Then you'll what?
Come on, Liz. He's just trying to have fun, just like you and me, you sad. Don't you act like you forgot, Mr. Happy.
What? If I can't hump your leg, then who can? I be stroking. That's
what I be doing. I be stroking. I think this is just me and you tonight. I stroke it to the east, and I stroke
it to the west. I could burn him with fire! Ooh, I can slit his throat! Ooh, I'm gonna smash him! I'm gonna smash him!
The next day, I told Liz all about my crazy night.
So I wake up this morning, and Muff is sitting on the floor, panting. My monitor is smashed in the floor. Isn't that crazy, huh?
Yeah, that is pretty strange. John, can I talk to you about something?
Sure.
Let's just forget about what happened last night.
Okay.
And you know I care about you a lot, right?
Right.
And I would never do anything deliberately to hurt you?
Okay.
Well, I guess what I'm trying to say is that Muff...
Oh, speaking of Muff, I taught him this pretty cool trick today. I taught him how to crap in the bathtub. He's such a good dog. I can't wait to bring this muffin home to him. Oh, by the way, I have to use the restroom. So if you could please excuse me, I'll be right back.
Cut my life into pieces. This is my last resort. Suffocation.
For some odd reason, Liz wanted to go right home after dinner. I didn't mind though, I fell right to sleep. However, I kept having these awful dreams like something bad was gonna happen. In the next few days, Liz was nowhere to be found. She told me that she had gotten a new job in the janitorial industry and that they were working her very hard. Whatever it was, I really started to miss her. So I came up with a brilliant plan to surprise her with flowers and chocolate. Should I have called her first? No way. Should I have knocked first? Maybe.
Yeah, you'll like that, baby. You like my big mop and bucket, don't you?
Needless to say, she was surprised.
John! You make me
dizzy. Do it.
With my newfound freedom, Muff and I had a great time together. We did everything together. Yet, everywhere I looked, I thought of Liz. I missed her. Even though I was glad I found out about her and Captain Buckets, I couldn't get her out of my head. We had been together for 4 whole months. You can't just erase those memories in an instant. In the following week of my life, I sank into a routine of pizza and porn. You really don't get to appreciate how much talent it takes to be in a porno until you watch Ren 10 10 K9 Cock 10 or 12 times. And it was in this perfect moment that everything came clear.
Oh my God. I don't just miss Liz. I love her.
Unforgettable. It was true. I couldn't get her out of my mind. I knew what my mission was. I needed to get Liz back immediately. The stage was finally set. Liz was on her way. However, my apartment wasn't exactly a chick magnet.
All right, boy. The woman of my dreams is coming right over. So no pissing, no humping. And please, no eating a shit. Got it? Now, I'm gonna let you out, and when you come back in, you're gonna be an angel, right?
You're such a good boy.
Reluctantly crouched
there you are,
at the
you
starting line.
Bitch.
Engines pumping and thumping in time. The green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flag...
How many times have you been pushed around? Is anybody there? Does anybody care?
Liz said she would be over in an hour, but in female time, that meant two. It didn't matter though, love was in the air, and I could just tell Liz was excited to see me. After all, she brought over some shredded meat to celebrate the occasion. Ah yes, Liz and I were back together. Life was great, except... Have you seen Muff?